about?
What a life. School all week and we have to take care of kids on Saturdays. It's the bunk, I say.
Believe me, brother, this guy's the last baby I'm ever gonna have. How'd you get your baby brother in the first place? Oh, I just prayed for a little baby brother, and the stork brought him.
Hey, what's a stork?
It's a goofy-looking duck on stilts.
Might be too cold to go swimming in the raw next week, mightn't it, uh-huh?
Uh-huh.
Say, fellas, I got an idea.
What is it?
Let's lock him up in the house and go swimming anyhow.
Mm-mm, that's out.
I'll let Cotton take care of himself once.
He ate a package of tacks, and a big hunk of stove polish, and $1.10 in pennies.
Remarkable. First any storks around Mike's on, I'll shoot him.
I'll tell you, we'll let Spanky take care of him. Then we won't have to worry.
Hey, you guys, where do you get that stuff? I don't take care of no babies.
Gee, that's a swell idea.
Hey, Spanky. We want you to take care of the baby before we go swimming, will you?
I should say no.
Oh, come on, be a sport.
No!
Oh, you're gonna get tough about it, huh? Supposing we tell the cops who broke Mr. Murphy's window, then what? They'll put you in jail, won't they, Stymie?
Yeah, my pappy says all you get to eat in the jailhouse is bread and water. And the jail's full of mice and rats and bugs, and they eat your toes off.
All right, but don't you tell those cops. Listen, you kids, if you sit still, I'll tell you all about Tarzan. Tarzan lived up in a great big tree. He couldn't talk to nobody. All he could say is, ooh, 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 it's like a hillbilly on the radio.
Remarkable.
It was lots of monkeys there, and they had on full overcoats. They all went like this. One day, a girl got lost in the woods, and her name was Jane. Tarzan liked her, too. And then he made monkey shines for her. It went like this. Then he ducked her in the water, and the tree get mad. Mm-hmm. Boy, did they have fun climbing around the tree. Mm-hmm. Pretty soon, a big old lion comes up, and he says, and then they had a fight. And then Tarzan smacked that old lion on the beezer. And then the lion smacked Tarzan on the beezer. And then Tarzan fell out of the tree right on his tummy.
Remarkable.
I say it's remarkable. Over there, it was a big old hippopotamus. And boy, was he ugly. Looked like the boogeyman. Over there was a big old rhinoceros with a toothpick on his nose. Over there, it was some billy goats and they had handlebars on their heads. Over there, it was a big old crocodile, and when he opened his mouth, he didn't have any face. He only had tonsils. Oh, boy, you ought to see the reindeers. They had rocking chairs on their heads. And then, it was an elephant had a long nose in front of his face. a great big lion comes up. And then they start to have a fight. And then a little monkey sees Collum getting whipped, and he goes for help. Be like a punk. Shut up. Collum and the lion was fighting hard. Pretty soon the lion came with his mouth open. And then he took out his knife and he stabbed right between the eyes and he fell down there and he got up and he ran away way off behind the bushes. Remarkable. Can you say anything but remarkable? Yeah. I love a Pete say it. Remarkable. Baby. It got to a fall there. Remarkable.
This is Station NIX. We are about to broadcast the second episode of our serial drama, The 13th Murder.
Remarkable.
You'll remember that Mary Dangerfield had been lured to the old haunted house by a mysterious message from Dr. Nemo.
Hello?
Some know me as Nemo, but I think you know me by a different name.
Hello? Number, please?
Look at me. Closely. Double-crosser.
Help! Don't kill me, please.
I'll see about it, ma'am.
Ben, listen. It sounds like somebody's being murdered.
Please, save me.
My gosh.
Oh, Miss Atair.
Hello.
Yes? Sounds like some bimbo's killing a dame. Listen.
Please.
Come out of that room, or I'll break down the door.
Help!
You better trace that call and call the cops.
Oh, yes, I will.
Help! It.
Boy, is he beating her up.
Calling car 28. Go to 1428 Maple. Man killing a woman.
Help! Help! Save me!
Put that gun down.
Oh, help! If you come in here, I'll shoot. I tell you.
Hey, come back here.
Here, crawl around to the front way. There you, keep low.
Now, I've got you.
Give me that gun. Don't shoot if you can help it. Bring him back alive.
Tune in at this hour next Tuesday for episode number 3.
The radio. That's where that call come from.
What's going on around here?
I don't know. We left Spanky to take care of the babies.
Well, where is Spanky?
I don't know.
What's that?